Hey everyone, welcome to this virtual lesson where we're going to be giving some medication to a couple horses that just had their wolf teeth out. So we're giving them some antibiotics prescribed by the vet as a preventative measure, because when you get your wolf teeth out, there's like a little tiny hole that has to fill in and close up, and so we want to make sure that they don't get any infection and that they're treated for that. So giving horses medication, we're gonna just go over a couple little things for if you're giving anything by mouth, and I'm gonna show you guys me giving the horses their meds out in the field. I find it's easier to just fill the syringe and go out into the field and do it, because our horses live out 24/7. If they were in the stalls, then we could do that. We're giving the medication twice a day, so this is the morning round of medication that I'm going to do, and then they'll get it again later on during the day. So the stuff that I'm going to show you is helpful for whether or not you are doing dewormer or medicine. There's a whole bunch of reasons why you might have to give a horse something by mouth, and this is going to just be helpful in general. For this particular antibiotic, it is TMS, so we have to make sure that we shake it and give it a really good hard shake, because the medication is actually mixed with oil, and what happens is when it's sitting in the bottle, it can just separate in the bottle, so you can actually have kind of the oil all separated from the medicine, and you might just draw up an entire syringe of oil, which is not good, because then the horse isn't getting the antibiotics, or you might try to draw up the antibiotics, which then would be super duper thick, because it wouldn't be mixed in with the oil, which helps make it thinner and something that you can draw up in the syringe. So now that we've given it a good shake, we're going to draw up our medication. So if it were dewormer, we would just set it to the appropriate dose. For this, we're gonna be drawing up. So what I'm gonna do is pull back and have air in my syringe. So the dose that the horses are gonna be getting is 30 cc's, which is 30 milliliters. And whenever I'm doing 30 cc's, I always want to draw up just a little bit extra, because chances are the horse is going to spit out some of the medication. So I draw up just a little bit more than that. So I've got 35 cc's, because I'm banking on the fact that not all of it's going to go in the horse's mouth. And I've drawn up the air, and now I'm going to push the air into the bottle. So that way when I pull back down on the syringe to draw up my 35 cc's, that I will actually have that ability to pull back. Otherwise, it's like trying to suck out of a vacuum. It doesn't really work that well. So once I pull back the liquid, there sometimes is an air bubble up at the top. And so what I wanna do is just go back forward just a little bit to make sure that it's actually all liquid in there and that it isn't an air bubble. Because sometimes it can look like you've drawn up liquid, but in reality, there's actually a big air pocket in there. So you wanna be careful that it's all liquid in there. It can be a little bit tricky, especially when the syringe is kind of white and the liquid is kind of white. So now we're gonna go into the field. It's raining a little bit, but we're gonna go in the field and I'll give you guys some tips for getting the horses their medication. I've got my halter and rope with me. Horses usually don't like the taste of the medicine, so you want to make sure you have the halter on them. They don't usually want to just take it by themselves, especially we're on day 3 now of giving this medicine. So the horses kind of know it's coming, and they might even start to walk away from me as I'm coming in, because it's not super pleasant for them. And because they have the little holes from the teeth coming out, we can't give them treats or grain or something like that, because it would get in the hole. So they have to have no grain for a few days. So it makes it a little tricky. So horses can be pretty smart and they don't always like medicine. So one of the things when I go to catch the horses I want to make sure that they don't necessarily see the syringe, because then they're more likely to maybe say no thank you and walk away. So I'm going to catch them first and then I'll turn on the camera and have the syringe ready. Right beside, and I'm pressing up against his cheek, so that way if he moves I can follow him. I'm holding, whoops, I'm sorry buddy,
I'm going to slowly put it in while holding his head up so he doesn't spit it all out. I'm putting it in slowly so I don't choke him. Now, I don't really want to leave it on a super bed note, so I'm going to just put that in again. So I'm going to put it the syringe in. And then I'm going to take it out on a good note there. Sorry, I kind of drifted out of frame there for a second. So you're holding the halter, and then you're kind of resting your hand on the horse's cheek. And you want to keep their head up so they don't spit it all out. Good boy. So I'm going to give him a little rub. I can't give him a treat because he can't have them right now. I'm just going to give him a rub, let him know that I don't hate him. Good boy, I'm sorry. And we want to make sure you always finish on that good note. And as you can see, there's some medicine that's kind of left on the outside of his mouth a little bit, which is why I give just a tiny little bit extra to make sure that he actually gets his full dose of the 30 cc's, but really small extra. And you have to be careful that you don't overdose, but know the medication that you're giving. This one has a pretty safe margin that if he were to be get a significant more, it's not going to really hurt him all that much. So I'd rather potentially give 4 extra milliliters, which are not going to hurt him, than not give him the dose that he needs. So, good boy. This is Chili. He's the other little guy that's going to get the medicine. So I'm going to do the same thing where I'm going to hold his halter. I'm holding the syringe with my thumb ready. I'm holding his head up a little bit. Press it in the side here. I can kind of hold the syringe and the halter at the same time. If he's got a lot of hay in his mouth, I want to make sure he has a chance to spit that out so he doesn't spit it out with all the medicine in there. So I'm just kind of holding there for a second to see if he'll spit any of that out. Putting a little bit in his mouth. See how he's dropping some of that hay as the horse goes cantering by. So I want to make sure that I don't put the medicine in and then he spits out all, any hay or grass that's in his mouth with the medicine with it. So I just put a little bit of medicine in there for a second. See how now he spat out a whole bunch of that hay there? Then I'll put in again. I'll give him the full dose now, slowly, so that way it doesn't shock him go down his throat. And you can see it's a little bit messy, like I got some on my hand and stuff, but that's why I put a little bit of extra in the syringe to make sure that he does get the majority of it. Got a big glob on the syringe here. Come on. There we go. Wipe that off on his mouth. So I kind of hold his head up to try to help him not spit out the medicine, but not so high that he can't swallow the medicine as well, because if your head's too extended, it makes it hard to swallow. And so instead we want to hold him up, but not super ridiculously high. Afterwards, make sure he knows that it's not the end of the world. I put that syringe in a last time, so that way he's not leaving on a super hateful note with that syringe. So good boy. You're a very good boy. Yes, you are. Hope you guys enjoyed that virtual lesson on giving a horse medication or a syringe by mouth, of how you can do that with them. The real big trick is just making sure that you balance your hand that's holding the syringe against their face, so that way if they're moving their head, you can move with them at the same time. And we're not grabbing with like a death grip of like, hold on to you, because that can usually cause them to be overreactive and not like that. So hope you guys enjoyed that virtual lesson. During this pandemic, we're doing some virtual lessons so that way people can learn about horses, since we're not able to do any riding lessons or camps or anything like that right now. And if you're able to help support the lesson horses at the farm, we're very appreciative of any support you have. There's a link to our website where we have a spot where you can help pitch in for a hoof trim or a deworming that's coming up in the spring. Which we'll be doing using these tips of how to do oral medication with the deworming coming up in the spring. And they just had their spring vaccines and teeth done and stuff like that. So every little bit helps, since the horses were not able to do our regular programming and stuff here at the farm. So thanks for watching, and thank you for all of your help and support. Every little bit helps, even if it's just $5, that is a third of the way there to a dewormer. So anyways, thank you so much, and bye for now. We'll see you at the next virtual lesson.